Hello friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor S.P. Singh from Faculty of Management Studies, Gurukul Kangri University, Haridwar. Today we are going to study Module 23rd on Career Development. Friends, after studying this module, you shall be able to know career development, understand types of career development, comprehend developing actions, become aware of the value of effective career development, understand suggestions for more effective organizational career development. Career development consists of the individual and organization actions undertaken to achieve a career plan. Career development looks at the long-term career effectiveness of employees, whereas employee development concentrates on effectiveness of an employee in the near future. Career development is a process that takes place over the life span and on the assumption that biological, psychological, social and cultural factors influence career changes and career withdrawal across the stage of development. The actions for career development may be initiated by the individual himself or by the organization. The study of careers takes on a very different orientation depending on whether it is viewed from the perspective of the organization or the individual. The career development from either of these perspectives is concerned with the interests of the individual. Career development is largely the outcome of actions on the part of an individual. Some of the important steps that could help an individual cross the hurdles on the way up may include performance, exposure, networking, leveraging, loyalty to career, mentors and sponsors, key subordinates, and expand ability. Career development comes through exposure to those who take decisions on promotions, transfers, and other career events. Individuals must undertake actions that would attract the attention of those who matter most in an organization. Networking implies professional and personal contacts that would help in striking good deals outside. Resigning to further one's career with another employer is known as leveraging. Professionals and recent college graduates generally jump jobs frequently when they start their career. To resolve this problem, companies come out with lucrative, innovative compensation packages in addition to employ such option plans for those who remain with the company for a specified period. A mentor is an older person in the role of a manager giving informal career advice to an employee junior in organizational hierarchy. Qualified and knowledgeable subordinates often extend valuable help that makes their bosses to come up in life. Career-conscious employees must prepare themselves for coming opportunities on their way internally or externally by taking a series of proactive steps. The assistance from managers and HR department is significant for achieving individual career goals and fulfilling organizational requirements. A variety of tools and activities are employed for this purpose. The employees go through a process in which they think through their roles, interests and skills, and work attitudes and preferences. Employee counseling is a process guiding employees in overcoming performance issues. Employment opportunities at various levels are made known to employees through information services of various kinds. Employee assessment programs, initially a new recruit is informed about career policies and procedures of the company. Socialization programs help the new employee learn these things rapidly. Employee developmental programs consist of skill assessment and training efforts that organizations use to groom their employees for future vacancies. Seminars, workshops, job rotation, and mentoring programs are used to develop a broad base of skills as a part of such developmental efforts. In recent times, there is an increasing evidence concerning dual career families creating tensions and frictions due to their inability to reconcile the differences between family roles and work requirements. Development of individual takes place mainly through his own efforts. However, the organizational support is necessary. Development actions by the organization include training, job rotation, job enlargement, special assignment, and deputation to other departments. Development action by the immediate superior include involvement, delegation, counseling and coaching, development actions by the employee, knowledge upgrading, skill building, and behavior attitude development. A long-term focus increases the organization's effectiveness in managing its human resources, ensures availability of needed talent. It provides assistance in attracting and retaining personnel and ensures growth opportunities for all employees. It also reduces employee frustration. Organizational career development managers can utilize different methods or tools to better match the career needs of their subordinates with the requirements of their organization. Challenging initial job dissemination of career options, information job posting, assessment centers, career counseling, career development workshops, continuing education and training, and periodic job changes make some of the methods of career development. Friends, in this module, you have studied the concept, types of career development, developing actions, the value of effective career development and suggestions for more effective organizational development. Thank you for visiting EPG Pathshala.